Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. If we look back at the last couple of days with the planetary conjunctions that we had on the 27th, 28th and also yesterday, we see some strong seismic activity that occurred on the 27th at the Solomon Islands, magnitude 6.1, and also several hours later, early on the 28th, at Hokkaido, Japan, magnitude 6. And as you can see, they pretty much coincided with the red peaks on the SSGI graph, which marks the planetary conjunctions with Mercury, as I explained in the last two updates. And yesterday night we had Earth in a conjunction with Venus and Uranus. And as that happened, a magnitude 6.3 earthquake occurred offshore Mol, Chile. And this was the area where in 2010 a magnitude 8.8 occurred. So what are we going to have in the next couple of days? As we look at the solar system, we see Earth, Venus and Uranus in a conjunction that was yesterday night. This may result in some stronger seismic activity, possibly today, tomorrow. To be honest, I don't think it's going to be much, but be on watch just in case. Then on April 3rd, Venus will again be in a conjunction with Mars and Saturn. We already had that a few weeks ago. It's going to happen again, and it will converge more or less with critical geometry on April 6th at full moon, and also a conjunction with Jupiter, that is the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. And in addition, we have Mercury, Venus and the Sun in a conjunction also on the 6th. So that will be a time to be on watch around the time of full moon, approximately from 4 to 8 April. In the solar system, we see this planetary and lunar geometry, Mars, Venus and Saturn in a conjunction. That will be on the 3rd, but it will still be very close in a conjunction in the following days, also around the time of full moon on 6th. And that will make it critical because we also see Sun, Mercury and Venus in a conjunction at the time of full moon. And we know what that can mean. Stronger seismic activity when we have planetary conjunctions converging with the full moon. And this configuration here is very apparent. We see the full moon and also the conjunction, the lunar conjunction with Jupiter, and that will be just after the full moon. Atmospheric fluctuations that we picked up in the last several days. I'm going to show you a few fluctuations that I also mentioned in the previous update, because they might still be relevant in the next few days. And it was on the 25th, southern Alaska and also the Loyalty Islands, north of India and towards Iran, that was from the 25th. And then also Central South America that we picked up on the 27th, and we've already seen a magnitude 6.3 in Chile. On the 28th, and that was a pretty active day regarding atmospheric fluctuations. Again, Guerrero, Mexico, that region, and we picked up some fluctuations there in the last week or so. And there may be upcoming larger seismic activity there in the short term. And this could be towards the full moon around April 6th. Also on the 28th, again, South Alaska and to the south, the Solomon Islands, New Britain region. And then finally, east of Kamchatka, Kuril Islands, and also to the south, the Mariana Islands region, Guam region, maybe the Bonin Islands and New Guinea region. This is the information that we have so far. Stay safe. Until next time.